Thanks for checking out this No Spoilers show review. This time I'm going to be talking about a show that is currently streaming on Hulu. It was originally on the channel AMC, which, by the way, AMC has a lot of shows just kind of like spread out over a bunch of different streaming services. But I do recommend The Terror. Like I said, streaming on Hulu at the moment, originally through AMC. It was from 2018, I believe. This show is very interesting, in my opinion. It looks really good. It's very well acted. And for people who are fans of Game of Thrones, you're going to recognize some of the actors in it because it has them. It has the guy who was Mance Rayder. It has a guy who was Edmure Tully. I think that was it. But you'll recognize those guys in there up front. The other thing is it has a guy of the hour, in a sense, who is stars in Chernobyl, the HBO show Chernobyl, which I will also be doing a review of, Jared Harris. He is a huge character. He's kind of the main character in The Terror, although there are a lot of characters. And he's basically the main character in the show Chernobyl. And I think these are both really good horror-related shows. So Jared Harris coming out of nowhere and just, like, killing it. So, like I said, the acting's really good in this. It looks awesome. The cinematography is so good. The directing is really well done. The set design looks great. The CGI that is used is nice. And one of the best things for me is the story idea with this. So, from what I read of the description when I was looking at the show, this is kind of going to be an anthology show based off the seasons. So this first season was one story, and then they'll do a second season, and it'll be a totally different story. But the focus is basically historical events, and then they're writing about it with putting their own horror twist on it. So injecting a little bit of fiction into factual events. And I find that very interesting, and this first season led to a very, very interesting horror setting, which is an expedition to the Arctic to find a pathway through, and they get stuck. And then there's some things that go on, and there's basically something out there that is not human. Is it animal? Is it supernatural? Like, you'll kind of figure it out as it goes on. It's 10 episodes, and each one is an hour long, and I feel like it moves at a pretty good pace, but even when it's not moving fast, there are very interesting characters and interesting character relationships to keep you involved. And honestly, for me, just kind of getting a window into the day-to-day of what they portray as being, you know, the operations of these ships, especially when these ships aren't even really fully operating, they're just kind of stuck in the ice, is really interesting. And the fact that, you know, lots of challenges come up because when you're stranded somewhere and you only have a certain number of supplies and people are kind of getting like cabin fever, and then you have another threat outside, and then you end up with a bunch of other threats that kind of materialize because of people being people. It's a lot that comes up. And the thing is, when I was watching it, they introduce conflict pretty early on, and what I thought was kind of going to be like the main conflict. And I was just like, man, what are they going to do with all these extra episodes after this? But no, they keep it moving. They keep it interesting, and they keep introducing issues. It's issue after issue after issue. And that's one of the greatest strengths of this film. In addition to being a very unique story, a very unique setting, especially for horror, which definitely keeps your interest on its own, the characters are really interesting, and all these issues that come up, and it's just like issue after issue after issue. It is dark. This show is so friggin' dark for that reason. So, what's your level of horror that you're comfortable with, basically? And a lot of the darkness comes out of, like, real-life situations. And it's just cool because it's kind of a look at, you know, when people are in these situations, what do they do? Like, you, as a viewer, you're just like, I think you should do this, or I think you should do that a lot of the times. And then, you know, you'll see these times where they take the total opposite approach to what you would choose. But I feel like they give you a really good, with this show, they give you a really good feeling and development to make you feel like you're in the environment. And they give you a good feeling of what it might feel like to be in that situation, which is why they make decisions that you feel like as an audience member you wouldn't make. So it seems like, I wouldn't go so far as to say it seems like the actions are justified, but you can understand how they got there and aren't necessarily like, well, that was stupid. That doesn't make sense. They make it make sense. And that's just great writing. And like I said, there's really good acting to go along with that. This is just an overall great show. It does feel slow, like I did kind of say a little bit. It feels slow at times, but there's a lot to look at. There are a lot of interesting interactions between characters, and there are a lot of characters to interact with each other. So even when it's slow, things keep moving, if that makes sense. I don't know if you guys, you know, does that translate? Do you know what I'm saying? But yeah, I was very, very impressed with this. It's a show that grabbed me immediately because of all the aspects of it that go super well. And just the story is really cool. I really like the story. They kind of lay out up front, like within the first 5 minutes, the outcome of the film. But that doesn't really matter because it's about how did we get here? Like, what are the events that took us to the end, even though we've already seen the end? And some people, when you see that, you may think like, well, I already know what's going to happen. That kind of sucks. Kind of like with a movie like Rogue One. Like, I felt like that film going into it, if you're a fan of Star Wars, you know the storyline that they're doing, and you know that in the end, it doesn't matter because you already know the ending, and you know where everything's going. But with this one, it is kind of that, where you know where it's going, but at the same time, you're like, yeah, but how did we get there? Like, you really want to know, how did it get to this? Like, how does this play out? How does all this play out? And you can't predict where things go. You really can't with this. Because like I said, things just keep popping up and popping up and popping up. And it is dark. Like I said, it is so dark. But I like that about the film. It was not afraid to go there. And their practical effects, they did a good job with it. Mixed with the CGI. There's action, there's horror, there's drama. It's very good. So I really can't say enough about recommending this. I don't think it's, like, perfect. It's not, like, the most amazing thing. But on a 5-star scale with half stars in play, I'm going to give it a 4.5. I think it's really well done, and I think that people should check it out. The only thing that I really didn't enjoy about this is there are some flashbacks in it that kind of give a little bit of backstory on some of the characters to kind of, like, tie them back home. But those didn't really feel like they mattered a whole lot to me. In the grand scheme of things. So they kind of seemed, in the end, more like time wasters that we didn't need. And you could have just kind of cut some of the episodes down a little bit time-wise. So that would be my only main issue, is that they just didn't feel like it was necessary. But yeah, 4.5 stars, obviously a recommend. If you haven't seen it, definitely watch The Terror, if you have Hulu, or if you can find it some other way. Have you seen The Terror, though? If you have, put your feelings down in the comments. Hit that thumbs up if you like this video or anything about it. But do me a solid. Hit that subscribe. I would love you forever if you do. It takes you like literally a second. So painless. Just do it, please. And spread the word if you don't mind. If you like the channel, anything about it, let people know. I would appreciate that. But anyway, thanks for checking this out once again. Until next time, keep it brutal.